Hello everyone, welcome to Ebenezer Tutorials. In this video, we will be looking at loops and how to write loops in Python and also about the jump statements that are available in Python. So we will start. We had already looked at a brief introduction of loops in the previous videos, but now we'll look at them in detail. So in Python, for loops, we can use the for loop and we can use the while loop. So we will see how to write the for loop first. So just as we have the other languages, here also we need an iterating variable. So the syntax is for, which is a keyword, the index, the iterating variable. So supposing I take I. Now here we have to actually traverse through a list or something which is an iterable. So here we can, most commonly we use the range, and we have seen what is the range and how to use it in the previous videos. You can go through it. So here in the for loop, what have I written? I in range of 10. So the values between 0 to 9 will be here. So I will be holding one value at a time. So in case I print I, so here we can see the output. It is 0 to 9. So this is how we use the for loop. We can have any kind of an iterable. Most commonly range is used. So, and by default the step in a for loop is 1, in this range function is 1. So now we will take another example. Now in case I want to iterate in the for loop incrementing 2 at a time, so I want the values as 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. So what will I do? We will have to mention the starting value. So in, I want it supposing as 10, 1, and I will mention the step as 2. So what will happen here? Here we can see it is having the step value as 2. Now we can also do it the other way around. So I begin at 10 till 1 and I want to go downwards. So I can mention, put the step as minus 2. So here we can see it is going 10 to 2. It won't take 0 because 0 is lesser than the the limit that we have mentioned over here. So it's starting from here and it is stopping at 1. So it won't go up to 0. So this is how we use the for loop. The step is optional. Also the starting value is optional in this range function. Now for the while loop, we will see how to write the while loop. The same thing if I want to do in a while loop, just as in the other languages, you need to have a variable beforehand initialized with some value, because the condition that we mention in the while loop will be using that variable. So it must have some value. So I will take the variable as j and I will initialize it with 0. Now we can use that variable. So if I write while j lesser than 10, simply print j. Okay, here we haven't incremented the value, so it will be j equal to j plus 1. That was the reason it went into an infinite loop. Here we can see, for now we will comment the, we will remove the for loop part. Here we can see we get the same output again, 0 up to 9. So while using the for loop, we must remember that the variable that we will be using in the condition must be defined already. It must already have some value so that we can compare it. And one more thing, to avoid the situation in which the loop goes into an infinite one, we have to increment and decrement it inside the loop. So how will this work? It will check the condition initially, 0 less than 10. Since the condition becomes true, it is printing the value, incrementing the value by 1, and then going back again to check the condition. If it is true, the process will continue. So this is how we use the while loop. And remember, indentation is one of the most important things in Python. So to show that these two statements are inside the body of the loop, we have these two, I have indented both of them towards the same line. Now we can check one more thing. I will do, we can just check it as plus 1 and we will do something else. Now this statement that I have written is not a part of this loop. So how do we come to know that? That's because of the indentation. So it's very important while coding in Python to indent the code properly. So this is how we use the while loop, and just as the other statements, we also have break and continue, which can be used in loops. So how do we use it? Supposing I want to mention a condition as if j is equal to 5. If j is equal to 5, I want to break. So what is happening? It will print the value and then it will increment it by 1. The moment after incrementing the value becomes 5, it will break out of the loop. That means the loop will not continue anymore. So we can see the output here also. It's printing only up to 4 because the loop stops after that. So this is how we use break. And so what does a break do? It breaks out of the innermost loop. Here I have only one loop, so it will just come out of the loop, so that the while loop is going to get terminated here. So similarly, we have the continue statement. So what will continue do? It will skip the current iteration. So here we are checking if j is 5. If j is 5, we are doing continue. So just for understanding this, we will put these statements down. So now see, before I explain the part, remember that this indentation is for the while loop. Now this indentation is for this if statement, and these two statements are again part of the while loop. That's why it's aligned in this one line. So what is this loop going to do? It'll check if each value is, if it'll check for each value. The moment the value becomes 5, it will continue. That means it will skip the current iteration and it will go back. It will not execute the remaining part of the loop. So we will see how to execute this, how it will work. Okay, so just one change we will have to make over here. We will check it with this example. So here what is going to happen is it will check if the value is lesser than 10. If it is lesser, it will increment it by 1. Now after incrementing, it will check if the value is 5. If it is 5, it will go back to the next iteration, else it will print the value. So we will execute this. Here we can see that apart from 5, all the values have got printed because it has gone back to the next iteration. Now, why has it started printing from 1 instead of 0? Because I have incremented the value before printing it. So that's the reason it has printed the value from 1 to 10 without 5. So that's how we use loops in Python and how we use the jump statements like break and continue. We will see some more examples in the upcoming videos. If you like the video, do give it a thumbs up and also share the videos with your friends and relatives. And don't forget to subscribe to Ebenezer Tutorials and press the bell icon for immediate notifications. Thank you for watching. Thank you for watching. Please like the video and also share it with your friends and relatives. And don't forget to subscribe to Ebenezer Tutorials to stay tuned. Thank you.